गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। अब वी स्टार्ट हियर प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ए एफ मैट्रिक्स। वी हैव सीन अर्लियर दैट प्रॉपर्टीज वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज अबाउट द स्क्वेयर प्रॉपर्टीज बिकॉज ए एफ मैट्रिक्स इज ऑलवेज अ स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स दैट वाई ऑर्डर इज अबाउट एन बाय एन दैट इज अबाउट द ऑर्डर ऑफ दिस एफ मैट्रिक्स। वी कैन राइट ए पैरामीटर दैट और वी कैन से दैट द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ एफ मैट्रिक्स बिकॉज वॉट that parameter is nothing but f of ij is equal to bi by aj. Here this f of ij it is given in that condition that at all the ports except port j is matched here. You just remember that f of ij, I is nothing but what we are getting that output at that particular, or we can say that reflection, and j is nothing but what we say that is about the input. Now S of ij is equal to what? B of I by aj here. This one is nothing but what? Your input we can say, and this is nothing but your output. Okay. Our input means we can say that is about the incident here at this particular port, or we can say that is the reflected, or we can say that is about the output at this given particular port. Now, if we consider that if port, we can say that if port I. If it is a match, if port I is what we can say that is about the perfectly match, what happened? If port I is match, then what happened? At that particular junction, we say that S of IA becomes 0. Okay? Because we say that is about the port I is match perfectly at that particular given junction. In that case, S of II becomes 0. And if we consider that a port I and J are not matched, okay, or you can say that, but they are, I and J are perfectly isolated. If port I and J is perfectly isolated, then what happens? S of IJ becomes what? S of JI is equal to 0 because that ports are isolated. And another property is about a, we can say that is about a, we can have a property, another property is what, it is about a, this S matrix is nothing but what we can say that is about the reciprocal network. Okay, we can say that is about reciprocal network. In that case, S of ij becomes S of ji. But the condition is that for I is not equal to, that is about the condition. And if we consider that if I and J are electrical symmetrical, okay, but we can say that with respect to what? With respect to supposed to be any of the component R now. In that case, what happens? S of II is equal to, we say, S of JI. And if it is I and J are electrical symmetrical with respect to any other port, in that case, can say that S of IR is equal to, sorry, S of JR. Okay, because I and J here, we say that is about I and J. But because they are electrical symmetrical with another port, so that's of S of I J is equal to S of JI, or S of IR is equal to S of JR. Now, then if we can say that if it is anti-symmetrical, now in that case, this is the condition of what? Asymmetrical. Symmetrical to what? Symmetrical to at symmetrical to given port or symmetrical with respect to another port R. If it is anti-symmetrical, then S of ij becomes what? S of ji. But we can say that if it is with respect to another port, in that case, S of minus jr. Okay. S of ir is equal to S of jr. Another property we can say that is about the unitary property. Unitary property means what? If we take a matrix, S matrix, and if we take a complex conjugate of it, so it becomes what? Identity matrix, or we can say that is about a I, that is 1. Okay, so generally we say someone say identity can be a 1 also. Okay, so don't get confused. Because we are saying we are going to obtain the product of what? Complex conjugate of itself. Okay, or can say that's about the conjugate of itself. So that is nothing but a unitary property. The next is about a zero property. Next is about a zero property. In the case of a zero property, here we can say that is about the unitary property. But in the case of a zero property, we just consider that a product of each term, okay, we consider that a product of each term of any row multiplied by any other row of complex conjugate. Means we say that here we need to find out a product of what? S of SPJ is nothing but what? SQJ, okay, and is nothing but a complex. That is about the conjugate of it, is nothing but 0. But in the case of what? P is not equal to Q. But here we can say that a product PJ and QJ, here P is nothing but what we can say? It can be of a row. Okay, but this Q is again a row for of row multiplied by any other row of complex conjugate. Suppose I have a S matrix. Now, I have to obtain a complex conjugate of S matrix. So, we will get this one. Now, one row of this one, another row of this one, likewise. So, we just consider that a sum of the product of each term of any row multiplied by any other row of what? A complex conjugate. So, that becomes a zero. So, similarly, we can find out a product of, okay, instead of row, we can consider that a column also. That in that case SIP is nothing but what? SIQ. Okay. SIP is equal to nothing but what? SIQ. And it is a complex conjugate. It is equal to 0. In that case, P is not equal to 0. Are you getting what I am saying? So this one, if you consider that this given particular port, here we consider that S matrix and its row here. That is about the row. Here we can consider the row. Here we can consider the column. Okay, so complex conjugate of what? We can say a row and a column. We will get that. That is about a zero here. Output will become a zero here. So next, we consider that if supposed to be, we can find out another property is about what? A unitary property. In unitary property, what happened here? So if we consider that if one row, okay, we can consider that any sum of the product of what? Here we have considered that sum of the product of row, okay, sum of the product of row and a complex conjugate of another row, okay, whatever the matrix we have, and we consider the row there, that becomes a zero. But here we have to consider that sum of the product of each term of any one column, okay, you can consider that any one column by its what? A complex conjugate, or you can say that by any one row, okay, we can consider that either sum of the product of a row or sum of the product of a column there, we just consider. Okay, here we consider that a sum of the product of here of ij, s of ij, but here we can say that is about the row here, but again the same row, but we can consider the complex of a the row. Suppose I say that we have a 3 by 3 matrix, okay, so this is about a s my here, we have a 3 by 3 matrix, again this is about 3 by 3 matrix. If I suppose to consider the second row here, and here we consider the complex conjugate of the same matrix here, again we consider the second row. So in that case, sum of the product of each term of any one row, okay, any one row multiplied by its complex conjugate, okay, its complex conjugate is unity. So this is nothing but 1, or we can say that sum of Sij square is equal to 1. Okay, that's about the simple. This for the row. Similarly, we can find out the sum of the product of each term. Okay, sum of the product of each term of any column, sum of the product of each term of any one column multiplied by a complex conjugate. We consider that here, we consider the 1. Okay, it becomes 1, or we can say that Sij square is equal to 1. Here we have considered that sum of the product. Okay, sum of the product of each term of any one row multiplied by what? Multiplied by its complex conjugate. Multiplied by its complex conjugate is unity. Okay, this one is unity. Now, if supposed to be I consider that of any one row, if supposed to be I consider the column, then this becomes the equation. Okay, just remember. So that is about we can say that A1, that we can say a row and column. Another property is about we can say for the S matrix is about a shifting property. In that case, what happened here? Shifting property, we got shifting of the reference plane. Okay, shifting property, or we can say that is about the reference plane. So now shifting of the plane means what? It does not change any magnitude. Okay, shifting of the plane, it does not change any magnitude. But what happened here? But where is the phase parameter? That is about your beta. Okay, so we can say that we can consider that phase shift here. That is about we can consider. Or we have if e raised to plus or minus j beta. Okay. So that about your change in a phase shift occur. Okay. So that is nothing but what? We can say that a property. That is about the shifting property of a reference plane. So what are the use of this S matrix here? Generally, we are using this S matrix in a microwave communication. Why? Because it provides a complete characterization of a network. What are the use of S matrix? It provides complete characterization. Complete characterization at what? At a microwave frequency. Okay, it provides complete characterization of microwave frequency. So generally in a circuit, we require a open circuit and a short circuit there. But here we can say that using this S matrix, we doesn't require that open circuit and short circuit for a given particular modeling circuit and all. S matrix is sufficient to obtain the whatever the parameters required. So S matrix are obtained using what? A match load. We have to consider the match load there. Then we can find out if there is no matching takes place at the given particular port, reflection occur. So now the reflection occur is what? The same thing. We say that incident here, we say that reflection. So using that, we can find out the properties of that particular, or we can say that a parameter of a F matrix here. We can obtain. Then we can consider that a simple port here. Any simple port, we can go ahead one by one there, and we so now we can find out the losses. Losses in terms of what? S parameter. Losses in terms of S parameter. Suppose consider that a port 1 is your input port and port 2 is the output port. Are you getting what I am saying? That port 1 is the input port and port 2 is the output port. Or we can say that, even we can say that is about the I. Okay. Don't get confused with P1 and P2. Okay. We can say that incident, that is about the port 1. Or we can say that is about the port 1 here. That is about the incident. So simply, we can find out incident and a reflection component at any port. Suppose I say that if PI and PR at what? At port 1. Okay. And P out is at port 2. Simply. Stop saying P1 and P2. It's simple. It's port. In that case, we find out the insertion loss. Insertion loss in DB. Insertion loss means what? Any particular microwave bench, if we supposed to be add any microwave component there, okay, if we add any microwave component, then we can find out the insertion loss. So insertion loss in a DB, so that is nothing but what? A 10 log of what? Whatever the component we have inserted here, in that case, is nothing but Pi by P out. And that is nothing but 10 log of, because we say that's about the incident. So incident is nothing but A1, and output is nothing but a B. So that's why B. A square, we say, B2 square, or you can say that instead of that, we can write here likewise. So it is nothing but 10 log of S21. Because 2 is output, 1 is input. So that's why the S21. That is about the S21. So for a reciprocal network, okay, if a reciprocal network is there, in that case we say that about S12 is equal to S21. In that case, 10 log of 1 by S21 square, or you can say that 10 log of 1 by S12 square, both are same because of the network, is a reciprocal network. Then we find out the transmission loss. Okay, what about the transmission loss? Because in a given particular network, we supposed to be consider that any network here, we can find out a transmission loss or a attenuation, because signal is propagating through this particular component. You can find out a transmission loss or attenuation in DB. So that is nothing but what, when we insert or we can propagate any signal, in that case we are giving the incident there. At the same port, it is reflecting one, and we are getting the output. That's why incident minus reflected at the given port and output. So if you solve it, we can say that A1 is at port 1 minus B1, because it is reflected at the port 1 itself, so that's why B1 here, and that is nothing but B2. Okay, so we can calculate that. This one is the square. Then if you solve it, 10 log of, we say that A1 square minus B1 square. Okay. So this one we have divided by, we say that the port is here, we can consider that A1 square. Simplified with A will be A1 square, which is square by A1 square. If you solve it, we will get that 1 minus B1 by A1 square divided by B2 by A1 square, so that is nothing but S21 square. And thus this term is nothing but what? S11 square. Okay, we can find out using this transmission loss is nothing but 10 log of 1 minus S11 square divided by S21 square. That's about it, transmission loss. And if you consider that, if it is a reciprocal network, in that case, S12 becomes S21. So our equation becomes, okay, it changes now. That's about your network. Next is about a reflection loss. So reflection loss is nothing but what? When we provide any input to the signal, we are getting that, okay, at the given same port, there will be a reflection. That reflection is nothing but depending upon that how much is your input, and at the same port what will be your output there. So that's why we can find out 10 log of A1 square divided by A1 square minus B1 square. And if you solve it, we'll get that 10 log of what? If we take A1 common output here, A1 A1 get cancelled, so we'll have 1 minus B1 square divided by. It is nothing but what? 1 minus S11 square. Okay. That is about a reflection loss at the same point. Next, about a return loss. If in a return loss, B when we provide an input to the given particular port, we are getting the output at the same port there. So we can consider that the chain log of incident A1 square divided by B1 square. Or you can say that chain log of, if you take a B1 by A1 here, it becomes what? AS11. So that is nothing but a return loss. So we find out here return loss, reflection loss, transmission loss, and insertion. Now that is about S parameters or S matrix to be used when we have a two port network, and we have to obtain that various losses. Now next we consider, or we can use this S matrix or S parameter to find out the S parameter or S matrix of E plane T, or we can say any junction. So right now we consider that E plane T is about E plane T. E plane T means what? E junction or E T simply, or we can say that a series junction. Some books they may say that series junction, some book they may say that voltage junction. Okay. This is about your series junction. Why we are saying it is about the series junction? Because the ports are looks like, that is about, you can say that the sidearm looks like in a series. That's why you can say that it is about a series junction. And when we are providing the excitation, or we are getting taking the output from the same port here, it looks like what? Appearing looks like that field. So that's why we can say that is about the voltage junction, electric field. Okay, so we can say that is about the voltage junction. Now, how E plane T looks like? So you know that a rectangular waveguide is about a rectangular waveguide. Now, in a rectangular waveguide, it is about a simple here in the rectangular waveguide. This one is about your rectangular waveguide. And for a given rectangular waveguide, we have seen that there is a field. There is an electric field. Nature of electric field in a E plane T is like. And for the given particular port, if supposed to be arm, if we take any arm at a given particular port, okay, now this is nothing but arm. Okay, this is nothing but arm we have taken. Now, this is a parallel arm to this what? To this electric field component. Now, this arm is parallel to what? Electric field component. So that's why this arm is called as E-arm, or this junction is called as the E-junction, and this T is called as the E-plane T. Okay, because here we have electric field component, it is parallel to this particular arm, that's why we can say that is about the E-arm. This one becomes E-arm, and this becomes your port, warrior port. Now, this is about your port 1. We say that while solving, or while obtaining the S parameter, we need to define the port number. So this is about your port 3. So in the case of a port 3, port 3 is perfectly matched to the given junction. Okay, condition is that port 3 is to be perfectly matched to the given junction, that at the particular given this junction there, it is to be perfectly matched. And port 1 and port 2 are electrically anti-symmetrical with respect to port 3. Are you getting what I am saying? Port 1 and port 2 are electrically anti-symmetric. Symmetric, it will be equal. Anti-symmetric, there will be minus sign. Okay. Port 1 and port 2, they are electrically anti-symmetrical with respect. Okay, when it is, when its collinear arm length are the same. Collinear arm length thing means what? This arm length. Okay. The junction means what? this length and this length, they same. Okay, that length, it has a same length. Then we can say that is about it. So we can say that is about collinear arm. Okay, this arm, port 1 and port 2 from this particular junction. Okay, same there. Now we can use this E plane T as a power divider. Or you can say that the, how it, we can say that the, about the anti-symmetrical. Now, suppose I take a cut section of this particular guide, a rectangular guide, if I cut at this particular place, then your rectangular waveguide looks like this way. I will draw here. Now, this is about your rectangular waveguide. Okay, so this one is about your rectangular waveguide. We say this is a port 1 and this is nothing but a port 2. Now, in this case, what happened? If supposed to be input, we are providing this is nothing but a port 3. That case, what happened? The field component will be looks like. You just remember that a direction here. So now, if you see that from this side, so this one is a port 1 and a port 2. They are looks like electrically anti-symmetric. Now, why are they electrically anti-symmetric? Direction of field is downward here, it is upward here. So that's why we are saying that port 1 and port 2 are with respect to what port 3 are antisymmetrical there. And the condition is that when this particular arm, that length is to be the same here. So this length, okay, this length, both the length is to be same. Okay, nothing. Now we can use this E plane T has what? A power divider. If you provide the input here, your output, if you provide the input to the port 3. Okay, so this one here at this particular place. What will happen? The power will be divided in a port 1. Okay, power will be divided in a port 1 and a port 2 with the same and equal magnitude. Okay, but what happened here? That is about that amplitude is same, but phase is changing. Now, if supposed to be this arm length is changes, then we will get the same phase output. So, if the arm, that collinear arm from this given junction are supposed to be same, then what happens? That output at the same, that particular place will be of what it looks like out of phase. So you can consider that when the power input is providing the port 3 there, so then output is available at port 1 and a port 2. And we can say that if your output, means we say that equally divided, we say. Suppose I am saying that the power is P now. What happened? Power will be available at port 1, that will be P by 2. At port 2, that will be again P by 2. Because it is equally divided. That's why we can say that this particular E plane T is a 3 dB splitter, 1 by 2. This is in terms of a dB, it is about a 3 dB. 3 dB. That's why we say that E plane T is 3 dB splitter. Okay, if you remember that, it is about a 3 dB splitter. But if you consider that the condition, if we provide, when it occurs, when we provide the input to the port, to which port? Port 3. Output will be what? Output at port 1 and a port 2. It will be what? P by 2. Okay. Now, if supposed to be, if we provide the input to the port 1 and a port 2. Okay. If we provide the input to the port 1 and a port 2, what happened to the power output at a port 3? because we say that if it is, because we say that earlier, output is equally divided in magnitude, but our topic it's supposed to be at the same time. Suppose if we are providing input to the port 1 and port 2 there, what happens? Same amplitude, same magnitude there, then power will be 0 at the port 3. Okay, power will be 0 at the port 3. Same amplitude and magnitude, sorry, phase, amplitude and phase there, in that case power output at a port 3 will be 0. If that it will be out of phase, then it will be combined. Okay, or we can say that port this E plane T will be act as a combiner, or we can use this E plane T as a divider there. If you provide the input to the port 3, power will be equally divided. Okay, that's why you can say that about the combiner, power combiner, or a power divider. But if you consider that, if we apply the power input to the one of the port, suppose I am saying that a port 1, in that case, power output will be available at port 1 as well as a port 3. But what happens? The power output are available at port 2 will be what? Suppose I am saying that input, okay, suppose if I am giving the input to the port 1, then what happens? Output will be available at port 1 as well as a port 3. And suppose to be input is a P, so output P will be port 1, there will be P by 4, and at port 3, there will be P by 2. If supposed to be I am given the input to the port 2, at a port 1, it will be P by 4, at port 3, it will be P by 2. Any of the port, if supposed to be I change either input at the port 1 or a port 2, okay, but the output will be at the port 2 or port 1 will be P by 4, but at the port 3, it will be a P by 2. You just remember that this will be act as a power divider or a power combiner. Now we use this, okay, whatever the thing what we have learned here, we use same thing and then we apply this law to obtain that a E plane T here. We will use this one, okay, the fundamental of E plane T, and that will be applied to obtain the S matrix of the S matrix of the E plane T. Okay, so now we consider that E plane T here. E plane T for a given particular port. So this is about your E plane T is nothing but what? This is nothing but your E plane T. In that case, your arm will be what? Okay, so this one. Okay, this is about your port 3. This is about your port 1. This one is about your port 2. And if you obtain, this is about it. It's three ports are there. So, S matrix for this particular E plane T will be of a 3 by 3 matrix. So, S11, S12, S13, S21, S22. S31, S32, S33. Now these are about your S matrix for this E plane T. Now how to obtain this each and every parameter for this S matrix? To obtain each and every parameter, now we consider that if we provide the input at port. If we provide the input at port 3, what happens? Output will be available at port 1 and a port 2. But that will be of what? Out of phase. Okay, output will be available at port 1 and port 2. That will be of out of phase. In that case, because we say that input is at port 1, input at port 3, so this becomes what? 3 here. Output we have taken at 1. Is equal to what? Input at port 3, output we are taking at 2. But it is out of phase. That's why S13 becomes a S23 because it is a out of phase. If that is condition 1, and if नोड 3 इज परफेक्टली मैच नोड 3 इज व्हाट परफेक्टली मैच व्हाट हैपन दैट S33 बिकम्स 0 इफ दैट पोर्ट 3 इज परफेक्टली मैच देन S33 बिकम्स 0 एंड फ्रॉम ए सिमेट्री प्रॉपर्टी because we have done that property earlier. So the same property we will learn from a symmetry property. If we consider that Sij is equal to Sji, Sij is equal to Sji. In that case, S12 is equal to what? S21. S13 is equal to what? S31. S23 is equal to what? S32. Now then, we just use this equation 1 we say, equation 2 we say, this one we say 3. Now if we consider that 1, 2, 3 here, and if we put that whatever the 1, 2, 3 we have received from this given properties and all, and if you put all the things in the matrix, S matrix there, what happened here? S11, S12. S12 here, because it is to be start with S21, because we have seen the property S12 becomes S21, so that's why S12 here. S22 here, it should be what? S23. Okay, it should be S23, but S23 becomes what? S32. Okay, S32 becomes what? S23 becomes what? S32, and that nothing but what? A minus here. Okay, this property, so that's why it is about it. And this becomes what? S31. S31 is nothing but what? S13. And S23 or S32 is nothing but minus S13. This becomes 0. This is about a S matrix. When we can put all the condition there, we will get this S matrix. Now, using a unitary property. Using unitary property means what? A complex conjugate of whatever the S matrix we have multiplied it will get that identity matrix. Then using this particular property, now we see that we find out this one. Now using that, if we consider that by multiplying row 1 and a column 1. By multiplying a row 1 and a column 1, we will get that S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. Because we have this matrix here, the complex conjugate of it means what? It changes. So if you consider that a obtain the S matrix, and if you find out a complex conjugate of it, it changes that rows and columns. And then after applying the unitary property to this particular S matrix and its complex conjugate, then we consider that by multiplying row 1 and the column 1, we'll get that S11, okay, S12 and S13. This one, because this one is a row here. Okay, this one is a row here. When we completely consider the complex conjugate, this become a column. Row, second column, third row, third column. Complex conjugate means what? So this becomes what? S11, because this row I am writing here, S13. Second row, S12, S22, minus S13. Okay, S13, minus S13, and 0. Likewise, so I change this. This is nothing but a complex conjugate. So now we apply this one, first row and a first column, it becomes a 1. That's about a unitary property we have seen earlier. Then we supposed to say that this equation is nothing but A. Now by multiplying row 2
column 2.
Here we say that row 2 and column 2. This one is about a row 2 here and a column 2. Same. Okay, we are multiplying with the same here. Why is complex conjugate? So it becomes what? S12 square plus S22 square plus S13 square equal to 1. Now, if we multiply row 3 and a column 3, then it becomes what? S13 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. This one is equation B. Now, using this equation, if you solve it further, so what will happen? This becomes what? Twice of S13 square is equal to 1. Or we can say that S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. Okay, one factor we have received now. Okay, that is about from equation C. So, this one. We can say that from this equation, we obtain that this one, S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. Just remember this. Next, using zero property. Using zero property means what? Sij into a complex conjugate of what? Sik is equal to 0. Where what we can say that j is not equal to k. It's row 1, column 2, likewise. So I am supposed to be multiplying row 3 and a column 1. If supposed to be I multiplied a row 3 and a column 1, we will get that S13, S11, it is complex conjugate, minus S13, S12, it is complex conjugate, is equal to 0. Okay, so now this one, we say that it becomes a equation D. Now equate the equation A and B by equating equation A and B. We will get that S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square is equal to S12 square plus S22 square. S11, S12, okay. We can have a S11 is it different here, S12, you can see that S12, S13, S12, S13, they will cancel. So we will get that only a S11 is equal to S22. You can say that this equation E. Okay. And already we obtained that S13. Okay, I think we see that this is nothing but a D. Okay, something D, E, and F. Now, this one we obtained the equation. Now, consider that this equation E now. By equation E, using this equation E, we get that S13 is equal to S11, it is about a complex conjugate, okay, minus S12 is equal to 0. We solve it, we get that S13 becomes 0. The condition is that, okay, that port, whatever the map, we say that it's about a match 1. We get that S11 is equal to S12 is equal to S22. So that is nothing but what? Equation G. If you consider that using equation you obtain that G and that D in equation what? B here. Use equation G and F and put that equation in equation B. We will get that S12 square, S22 square, S13 square is equal to 1. okay, after 5 minutes, meeting will be over. You again join. Then, this one is equal to 1. If you solve it, because S13, we say that earlier it is about 1 by root 2. If you put here, S12 is nothing but what earlier we say that S12 is nothing but S11. We say that S12 is equal to S11. Plus S22 is nothing but what we can say that, okay, S12 here. So simply, this S22 and S11 is nothing but S11 square. So then it becomes a 1 by root 2, that is square, so that part is a 1 by 2, is equal to 1. So then we solve it, we get that S11 square, okay, is equal to 1 by 2. This one, if we solve it, we get that 1 by 2 here. So that is about it, minus 1 by 2. So then if we solve it, it becomes, your equation becomes what? This becomes minus 1 by 2, so you get the plus 1 by 2 there. So that your equation becomes S11 is equal to 1 by 4, then S11 becomes 1 by 2. Again, we are getting the top. So now we have received that S11 will be S12, S13 is equal to 1 by root 2, that we have received the term. And if you put that term there in this particular equation, this matrix equation, S11, S12, because we have seen the properties and all. In that case, our S matrix for the E plane T will be what? 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2. 1 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, and is equal to 0. That is about the S matrix. This one is about it. S matrix for what? A E plane T. Or you can say that is about the series junction. Or some books say that it is about the voltage junction. Okay, all of you just remember that. This particular thing, what I am saying. And this is nothing but a E plane T here. Now, okay. We just learn here. Once the meeting is closed, okay, so that's about your meeting.